How we doing, sir? The reason I'm stopping you is I followed you for about 2 miles and you were sleeping. Sir, I was upside of you. I was looking at you and you were doing this. Your eyes were closed. You're telling me you were not sleeping.
I was tired.
Well, you're going to get a ticket now because you were sleeping. I'm not going to argue with you.
On May 16, 2021, Deputy Gomez observed a 38-year-old driver that appeared to be asleep behind the wheel crossing over the Illinois-Wisconsin state line. Deputy Gomez noted that the driver's head was down and he was not looking at the road. He went behind the vehicle, hit his lights, and for about 2.2 miles, there was no reaction from the driver. It was indicated that the driver was traveling at 82 miles per hour. After no reaction, Deputy Gomez went to the upside of him again into the number one lane to see if he was awake. Eventually, the driver finally noticed he was being stopped when the deputy pulled alongside the Tesla for the second time.
He was totally sleeping. Totally.
I'm keeping that block.
Perfect.
Step out of the car. Step out of the car, please. What? Three?
How we doing, sir? The reason I'm stopping you is I followed you for about 2 miles and you were sleeping. You were totally like this in the car. Why would we drive like that?
I was okay.
You were sleeping.
I was a little bit tired.
No, you were sleeping, sir. I was upside of you. I was looking at you and you were doing this. Your eyes were closed. So I understand you have autopilot, but if something was to happen, you're not able to make that conscious decision to stop in a hurry.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying? Can I get a driver's license?
Of course.
Have you been drinking or anything like that?
No, sir. Okay. Yeah, I'm just on my way to work.
You're on your way to work and you're sleeping?
Yeah, I'm just on my way. I'm not sleeping, but I'm, you know, like I said, I was just tired.
Piper.
Do you have insurance as well?
I don't have the card. I have a...
Okay, you have it on your phone?
Yeah.
Okay. So you're on your way to work, but you're sleeping.
Well, I'm not sleeping, but like I said, I'm on my way to work.
Hey, we had a person call you in sleeping.
Okay.
And I saw you
sleeping. They followed you from Illinois all the way to Highway 50, and then he got alongside you, and you were knocked out.
You were like this, with your head pointed that way.
Like I said, I am tired. I'm on my way into work. But.
I get the auto option, but you still have to be awake and doing things. You're not able to make a quick decision.
Yeah.
I don't have the
full service yet, you know. I don't think it's available for everybody.
241, 44.
Okay. I'm going to run your license. I'll be right back, okay?
Yep.
Hold on.
The driver denied being asleep at the wheel, explaining that he was okay, slightly tired, and worked 7 days a week.
Nothing illegal in the car?
No, sir.
235, Sheriff, in Illinois 27.
No medications or anything like that?
No, not
do you mind if I look inside the vehicle?
Yeah, go ahead.
All right.
What was that, Sam? 326 of 83.
Keep an eye on him. It says it's on autopilot.
Yeah.
it wouldn't be turned on. You can't turn it on.
It says it's on.
You can't turn it on when it's off. Like when you're parked, it's off.
But so it says it right on the screen, navigation on autopilot. Huh? See the blue? Read the blue.
Okay. Well, there's no way you were driving your car like this. There's no way. I'm just telling you.
Slide back over there.
Yeah, come over here for us. There's no way you could be driving your car when I'm upside of you and you're sleeping. So I'm just telling you, sir.
No, I understand.
Or you would have been all over the road.
Just have a slide back to the bathroom.
Yeah, just over here for us, sir. I haven't dealt much with this, I'll be honest with you, because some of these cars don't do this. Some of them do. So this will be the first time I've ever dealt with this. But there's got to be some restrictions that say you don't just put it in autopilot and then go to sleep. So no, that's one thing I'm worried about.
And again, that was not the situation.
How can you say that when I watched you sleeping? You're trying to tell me you were awake when I know you weren't.
I understand. I was tired and I should have probably pulled over.
I had my lights and sirens going for about 20 seconds and you didn't pull over. Then I got behind you, told dispatch you're not acting. You're doing nothing to my lights.
Okay.
You're still sleeping.
Okay.
Finally, you woke up and then come over to the side of the road. But I've got a time delay. It's recorded. Cameras, everything recorded. And you weren't doing anything. And I was following you with my lights going.
Sure.
Sirens, which means you were sleeping. It's okay. Just be honest.
That's not the situation.
What's the situation then? I want to hear what you say it is.
Sure. I was tired. I apologize.
So you're telling me you were not sleeping?
I was tired. I'm not tired. You know,
were you sleeping in this car?
I was not sleeping.
Okay. Well, you're going to get a ticket now because you were sleeping.
I'm not
going to argue with you. Okay. No problem. I'm going to look up what the statute is. I'm not real familiar.
It's inattentive.
Driving type ID on tracks and you're done.
Okay. It's all on my camera too. And I had the lights going behind him for a while after I was inside of him. If he wasn't sleeping, he would have saw me.
I used my body cam to capture that it is on autopilot.
Okay.
So,
give me 1 second.
The vehicle can't be on autopilot when it's parked.
No, it just shows that it's on autopilot.
Sure. Yeah, but it cannot be on autopilot. It could only be on autopilot if another person is actually holding the steering wheel.
Okay.
Yeah. So I mean that's like, you know.
Yeah, that's just crazy, man. It's scary to think, like, he got alongside of you, man. That's why all three of us came.
If someone's not holding the steering wheel for 30 seconds, it will automatically turn off autopilot for the rest of the meal.
You know how long he's been trying to pull you over for?
No, I don't.
It was a while.
Okay.
It was a while.
Yeah.
At least from the state line, because I saw you pull in and I took off to go with you.
Well, no, I think Dave got behind him at either 50 or 158.
Shots fired from this morning.
You can look up the statute for reckless. I mean, like he said, it may be borderline reckless. If he's crashed out like that.
Totally sleeping. So what is the purpose of these autopilots then?
These autopilot things, oh my God. I'm telling you, I've been by people, they've been awake. But their hands aren't on the steering wheel at all.
Yeah, and they're doing things.
I had one lady that she was like riding and like almost like looking at a book, typing on a computer, drinking coffee.
I had a 13 Tesla. It didn't do that though.
Yeah.
I would think that they would have some type of safety that says every minute you have to do something to the wheel so you're awake.
He said you have to have your hands on the wheel.
Oh, it was like this. And I was trying to get his attention. He was looking
that way.
He's
just like a loose cannon going down the road.
And I'm doing the, I got my light sirens going. And then I pull behind him, and he's still nothing, but it's perfectly straight because it's keeping him there.
Yeah.
But I'm going, and then finally he woke up and saw me and jerked it to the right. Like, we're going to the car. And he stopped. So,
yeah, that's scary, man. Right? Yeah, inattentive or reckless. I mean, you'd have to look to see what the reckless statute says.
I think he has to be doing something that would promote reckless with other cars by him.
Yeah.
And there was cars by him, but there was no.
You definitely have inattentive, man. Yeah. He's out cold.
Out. He's saying he wasn't.
Yeah.
It's so obvious. I'm not going to argue with you.
You don't have to argue with him.
Yeah, it's a sir, you are not awake. He would have told me, I fell asleep, then that'd be different. Not that I still wouldn't issue a ticket, but I just hate when somebody doesn't want to tell the truth.
You may have been out so hard he didn't even know, man. You know, like, sometimes when you're, like, sound asleep and somebody wakes up and you're like, hey, man, you're sleeping. No, like, wasn't
what?
It?
Yeah. But how long?
Right. Hang on. Oh.
All right, can I have you step out so I can talk to you out here? I just like to be out here. I'll have you come over here behind my car. Right here's good. So I have a question. Do you have any medical conditions? Do you suffer from narcolepsy or anything like that makes you just fall asleep?
No, sir.
You have nothing like that?
No.
Okay.
I'm just on my way to work. I saw another officer. I'm a FedEx driver. That's all. Like I'm just on my way to work. I work 7 days a week. I felt was tired. I might have been a little bit tired. And I'm really honestly just not trying to lose my job. And that's
okay. What I'm going to do is I'm going to be issuing a citation for inattentive driving. That means you didn't have your eyes on the road while you were driving the car on the road. Okay? Second thing I'm going to do, and I'm going to end up towing your car. Listen, before you say anything.
Oh, my goodness.
You have had two priors last year for the same thing. People called you in August and February of 2020, where they observed you on the interstate sleeping.
That's in our county. We don't even know about Illinois or Racine County or anything. That's two priors in our county. This is your third time of people calling you and sleeping in this black Tesla.
So I'm going to tow the car. You can pick it up later or with somebody that's not what I believe to be sleeping, tired, unable to drive their car.
Okay.
Or you can, the best thing is I can take you somewhere, either the gas station or wherever, and then I'll give you the tow information who's got the vehicle. It's going to be Jensen's. I don't think you're safe to drive right now. If you were to take off and get in an accident, it would be me, and I don't want to be responsible.
Here's
your citation for today's incident.
The other thing, he's going to do a driver condition report.
Yep.
That's going to go to the state DOT just to have you checked out because we can't have you sleeping behind the wheel, man.
Yep, I'm doing a full report where they're going to bring you in and talk to you and figure out, do an investigation. It's called a driver condition report.
Okay.
Because of what's going on, I got to make sure everybody's safe. And to me, that's not being safe, sir. Okay? So I'm going to have you sit in my car and I can either give you a ride to a gas station, but you can't take the car.
I can't go to work today, then?
You can probably go to
work. You just got to find a ride. We're not going to let you drive.
I mean, it's all the way in Cudahy. I don't know how I can make it from...
Well, I would get on your phone. I can take you to either a gas station, a truck stop over here, where somebody can come pick you up, let them know you're going to be a little bit late. But right now, you can't take your car.
I know. It's kind of an emergency at work because, like, I have to be there. I'm already late. And
okay. I think this is more of an emergency that we keep everybody safe, including
no,
you.
No, of course. Safety is absolutely.
Yeah, that's why I'm doing this, sir. Okay.
Is there any way around like where I can continue and kind of go to? Like, I understand that this is the issue. Like
you're trying to say I should let you get in the car and drive away? There's no way, no, sir.
Well, I understand the citation, and I'll definitely address this.
Okay.
Is there any way I can commute to work today? And then,
you drive for work, right?
Yeah, I'm a full-time driver. Yeah, I drive all day long. Jeez. So it's not an issue. Like, I drive all day. I drive 7 days a week. You know, like, so it's like,
okay,
this is what I do.
Well, this is what I'm gonna do is take you to a truck stop. I gotta take you somewhere because you don't have a car here, and you can make a call to get to work.
Is your phone in the car?
My phone is in my pocket.
Okay.
Yeah, why don't we just do that? Get out of here.
I'll have you sit in my car, sir. I need you to sit in my car, sir.
Okay. My wallet is in the.
I'll get that for you.
Is it in the?
It's in the cup holder.
Okay.
Okay.
We'll secure it all up and everything. Do you have a key for it?
The key is within the little wallet thing.
Okay. He said the key's in the wallet thing there.
Oh man, my signal's okay. Not working.
Is that your key?
Yeah, it's in there. It's
okay.
In there. It's
yep, everything's
wallet.
In there.
Right there, like
yeah, I had a Tesla, yeah. It's not as nice as this one, but they're good, nice cars. Okay, I'll give you this. We'll have a seat in my car, and you can use your phone, and it'll get a better...
Make sure you let me pull out my door.
Yeah, we'll get a better signal if we go over here to the truck stop. That's a better place to wait, in my opinion. Because then somebody can come get you and take you to work. And I'll give you a card as to where your car is going to be. And if a friend comes, he can take it. I just don't want you driving it.
Like, it's being there towed at what time?
Watch him, Terry, for a second. Can you stand over here for me?
Yeah,
thank
you.
I gotta unlock my door. Can't reach in there. Yes, you can. Thank you.
Now put your seatbelt on.
Sure. What time will it be towed there?
I'm sorry?
What time will it arrive there?
At
Jensen's, the car?
He'll be there in about half hour. I would say. They're going to be here in 5 minutes.
Okay.
Takes them about 15 minutes to Jensen's. I'll give you a card where it's at. If you can have somebody come, they can pick it up.
That's fine.
As long as you're not by yourself, they won't let you have it right away because we're going to tell them you can't come by yourself and get the car right now.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
Okay. All right. I'll talk to you more through there. Okay, cool. Thank you.
Yeah,
you I just felt so way. Close. I didn't want to reach in here. I couldn't.
I got you.
All right. I'm going to take them over there right away, but shouldn't it be secured? Maybe the window's up and stuff?
Oh, they'll do all that.
Can they do it without the key?
Where is the key?
He's got it with him.
Oh, we need the key.
Oh.
You have the key?
That's the key?
Yeah.
Wow.
It's crazy with these things, man. I'm going to set on the deck.
Yeah.
I'll do all that.
Okay. And then they'll have the key for him. Are you going to give instructions to that driver? Not. I said give instructions to the driver not to let him come and get his car. He's by himself.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You know anything about Teslas?
All electric.
Yeah, the key's in it. It's that little card on the dash.
Okay.
This dude was asleep. Driving down the interstate, they tried to, we had calls on him from the state line.
Oh, wow.
And then the deputy got behind him at 158, lit him up, and drove all the way here before hitting the siren, everything. He was out cold. He's driving, is on autopilot. And then I guess it's like his third offense.
Come on, if you don't learn from the first two,
yeah.
Do it again.
I don't know.
Oh,
so.
Shit.
There's the cards in there, I don't know. Yeah.
Okay.
I don't know how to start it or anything like that.
You and me both.
It's all done off that computer screen. Once you open the door from the driver's side, that screen comes on. I'll show you.
Alright.
Like you push this and it opens.
Wow.
Maybe. It was opening. Oh, there we go.
Shut up.
But that's the key. And then that screen is how you do everything. I don't know anything about these.
Or, I mean, I can try driving it up there.
Yeah, if you know how to drive it.
Well, I got it figured out how to put it in gear, so.
Okay. That's what I would do.
All right. What a morning.
Yep.
I'll pull over here, so. I have to pull right up front there. Is that a handicap?
That side. All right.
Okay, sir, you can step out. Do you have any other questions for me? You know where Jensen's is, right? You found it on the...
No, I don't have data yet, so I'm going to have to figure out.
I can get Jensen's for you and give you a pen here.
Okay.
Jensen's Towing, Kenosha, Wisconsin. Okay? So, yeah, you can go up the side of the building here and go right on in there and have somebody call whoever can get here. But they have your car, and they'll be standing by. Once you bring somebody that can pick it up, you can pick it up right away.
Gotcha.
Okay? I wish you luck, sir. Okay?
Okay. All right.
I hope you don't take it the wrong way. I just want to make sure everybody's safe. And being that there's two prior calls of this already within a year, this is a third. I think you should maybe see a doctor as if, because you told me I didn't think I fell asleep. So I would definitely at least just get his opinion to see. I hate for something to happen. But that's up to you. Thank you for your cooperation, sir. Good luck to you.
The Illinois driver was issued a traffic citation for inattentive driving. Sheriff's officials said they hope the alleged nap serves as a wake-up call for other drivers. If you guys enjoyed the video, please leave a like, as the footage featured on this channel may be costly and can take several days to process prior to being obtained, along with the time dedicated to editing. Thanks for watching, and I hope you're able to gain some insight from this. See you in the next one.